In this video, we'll learn how to use gestures in Adobe Fresco. Now, chances are you're using Fresco on a device with a touchscreen, so learning gestures is a really great way to make your workflow a little bit faster and a little bit more intuitive. So you can see I've got a document here in Fresco. Let's go ahead and take a look at a few gestures that can help us to zoom, rotate, and pan our canvas. So with two fingers, we can touch and drag to pan side to side or up and down. We can also do a two-finger twist to rotate the canvas, and that's really nice if you'd like to align yourself to a specific drawing angle. We can pinch in with two fingers or out with two fingers to zoom in or out. And if we'd like to return to our default view, we can do a quick two-finger pinch inwards. Now, it probably goes without saying, but all the gestures we've seen so far don't actually make any changes or edits to the imagery in the file itself. We're just changing the preview that we see on screen to make it a little bit easier to work. Next, we'll take a look at a really cool gesture for using the eyedropper. So this allows us to sample any existing color from our canvas. All we're gonna do is a single finger long press. You can see that jumps me right to the eyedropper tool. Now, as I move over the canvas, notice how my color chip is changing and picking up all of the colors that I'm moving over. So I can take that orange color, maybe do some details down here. Now we also get the option to do a slight variation on that eyedropper by sampling multiple colors. So this requires us to use the touch modifier. I'll go ahead and tap and hold on that, and then tap and hold with my other finger to do a multicolor eyedropper selection. So notice as I'm moving around here, the preview that I'm getting on the color chip, it's not just one color, it's actually a small selection of the image. So maybe I want to keep something like that. And now when we draw, we're basically repeating that little segment of the image that we sampled. So that can be a really cool way to draw. This is probably a good place to look at undo and redo. So if we'd like to undo the last step, we can just do a two-finger tap, and I can two-finger tap again to keep going backwards. Now, on the other hand, if I want to redo, I can go ahead and do a three-finger tap, and that will bring those changes back up. We could also use a long press gesture on any of the toolbar icons that have a little triangle in their bottom right corner. So, for example, I can tap and hold on my pixel brushes, and this gives me access to lots of different variations and brush settings that I can use as I draw on my document. Now, sometimes we find that we want to move this whole popover into our canvas so that it's always available. So there's a gesture for that. We can just tap and hold on the little bar at the top and just pop that right out to our canvas. Now, as you can see, my screen's getting a little bit crowded here, so let's X out of this for now. And our last gesture, we'll actually need a blank document. So let's go ahead and jump back to the home screen and let's quickly create a new one. Now, I've already got a template here, so I'm just gonna click on that and we'll jump right into a blank file. So this is a really fantastic gesture that helps you draw perfectly straight lines. So I'm just gonna go ahead and try to draw a straight line without using this gesture. And you can see this is sort of straight, but not quite. So let's try this again, but when I get to the end of the stroke, I'm going to touch and hold, and you can see Fresco is smart enough to snap that straight line between the starting point and the ending point of my touch gesture. So we've covered some really important gestures here, but there are still a few additional ones that we don't have time to talk about. You can see those under the question mark icon by clicking View Gestures. So this gives a nice illustrated list of all the gestures that are available to you in Fresco. All right, so that's how to use gestures in Adobe Fresco.